Good morning, guys. Happy Christmas Eve. Thank you for joining me. It's currently 23 degrees there at Yellowstone National Park. Winds are about 14 miles an hour. I'm not sure how gusty it is, but it's currently snowing. And here we have a live view of the Old Faithful webcam there at Yellowstone National Park. This hill back up over here, that is one of the two resurgent domes there at Yellowstone. A resurgent dome is the dome as the lava or the magma pushes up from under the ground, forming this hill, which is called a resurgent dome. This is the Mallard Lake Resurgent Dome. USGS isn't reporting any earthquakes so far today for the Yellowstone area. 27 earthquakes in the last week, and we got the Snake River Plateau through here, Hedgin Lake, Yellowstone Lake, and then the Grand Tetons. This is the area where the last major eruption, it blew the mountains out. But there has been earthquakes here. We got one at 7:41 a.m. Universal Time. This top monitor is the Madison River area. The middle one is Little West Thumb. And then down here at the bottom, we got Moose Creek, Idaho. Being the weekend and being the holiday weekend, you can technically say it. It's Friday, December 24th, 2021. USGS often is closed on the weekends. This earthquake right here, which comes from Moose Creek, Idaho, comes in as a magnitude 2.89. And we'll go to the spectrogram. Yeah, look at that. All the hot gases and hot water that came up. Marked in red, so a message was sent to the geologist. Someone probably just hasn't checked their phone for text messages. The monitor on the left is the borehole from the Madison River area. The one in the middle is Moose Creek, Idaho, and this is Little West Thumb. It actually looks like there was two earthquakes here. You can see it right there at the borehole for the Madison River. This is borehole 207. Looks like we got another small one, and this all looks like harmonic tremors, but it looks like, yeah, there's another small earthquake there at the borehole at 12:45 Universal Time, and that comes in as a magnitude 1.95. We'll look at the spectrogram. The monitor for Moose Creek, Idaho, I've been using lately because it picks up the earthquakes that are located along the Sawtooth and the Snake River Plateau, Stanley, Idaho, etc. We got another one marked in red right there. That comes in as a 1.88. We got another one right here. There's another one right there. That came from the south. How do I know it came from the south? Because the main line, probably the P wave, points down. If it points down, it means it came from the south. There's some other small ones here. Let me bring this over. Let's see if I can find it. Another one there. And there's another one buried right there. That came from the north. See how it points up? None of these USGS is reporting. For some reason, the monitor for Moose Creek, Idaho went offline. You can see all this bear down here. One, two, three. Let's see, we got one, two, oh, excuse me, four, probably about 4 hours. Maybe about the last 3 hours, it has not been recording. The monitor for Little West Thumb. Now, you know that, let me show you Google Maps, or actually Google Earth. This is Little West Thumb. This is considered a small caldera right there. And you know about the crack, those that follow me, that is 350 feet below the surface of the lake, and the water down there is between 340 and 350 degrees. But they got a large crack where the magma is trying to come up. And often we have show up activity for here. And then also for the area of the promontory, which is down here. And I've talked about the blobs of magma that's been trying to come up. That's their actual scientific term, blobs of magma. And that's where we have the thickening of the lines. And we got the volcanic tremors. And let me bring it down what it was showing when I pulled the files this morning. Right there. Yeah, the line of melt. Not all rock melts at the same temperature. And when you got dike intrusion, you get different layers of rock that is melted. And we'll pull it up a little bit. Looks like it started showing up. Let's see. It comes and it goes. We'll pull this over right there. We got several very small microquakes. This looks like to be the biggest one right there at 1718. And that comes in as a magnitude 2.16. And I'll pull it back up so we can look at the spectrogram right there. There's another one they have marked in red right there at 1319. And I'll pull it down. It comes in as a 2.04. We'll pull it down so you can see it there at the bottom. 2.04. And we'll go back to the spectrogram. Steam has been off and on a little dirty. Not too bad. Once in a while you'll see a gust of wind making the trees blow. So are you guys all ready for Christmas? The best that you can, you know, can be. I'll be glad to get it all done and over with. Get the packages out of my house. My apartment's so small, it's hard for me to put things up and out of the way so the grandkids don't find them. I wish everybody see the tree starting to shake a little bit. I wish everybody a very Merry Christmas. I certainly hope 2002 is going to be a better year. And I'll keep watching, as I always do, what's going on at Yellowstone. Just more of the same as it recharges for the next coming eruption. And only God knows when that's going to happen. So, if you have any thoughts or questions or comments, please put it down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you very much for your support. Yeah, you guys are wonderful. Thank you for taking your time to watch. And have a very Merry Christmas. God bless y'all.